it's Janet. I'm a children's librarian at the Wilmette Public Library, and welcome to the Halloween edition of We're Gonna Make It, Simple Crafts for Complicated Times. Halloween sure is complicated this year. Do we celebrate at all? If we do celebrate, how do we celebrate safely? Do we dress up? Do we go trick-or-treating? Do we hand out candy? It's up to you and your family to decide. But if you do decide you want to go trick-or-treating or hand out candy, the Village of Wilmette has some nice guidelines that will help you do this all safely. What I took away from those guidelines is when you're celebrating Halloween, you should do what you normally do in these times. Wear a mask, keep a safe distance from others, and keep your hands clean. And get treats. When it comes to handing out candy, I think that means that you definitely want to keep your hands clean, wear a mask, touch the candy as little as possible, and keep a safe distance from the trick-or-treaters. I've come up with a few ways to hand out candy safely and creatively using common household items. You may have seen the treat tube on TV or online. To make one, you could buy some piping or you could look around your house for some tubes and make it with what you have at home. I tried this first with some wrapping paper rolls taped together. When you're picking a tube, make sure that it's clean inside. And also, make sure that the tubes you put together are the same diameter. And make sure that your treats will fit inside. You don't want them to get stuck. Now, after I made my wrapping paper tubes, I actually found some wider tubing in my house, and I decided to try that. So, what you do is you put your tubes end to end on some duct tape, tape them together, and then measure it. Make sure your tube is 6 feet long. Great. It's exactly 72 inches. If you want, you can decorate your tube. I would do that after you tape it, just in case you have to do some retaping and untaping and retaping. Okay, I think we're ready to test this in the front of the house. Let's go. The actual treat delivery will depend on how your house is set up. What I'm hoping I can do is set up the treat tube on the railing of my front steps. What I've already done was to measure 6 feet away from where I think I'll be standing. So I took my tape measure, that's over here, and I measured 6 feet out from the top of my stairs. I thought of the stairs as a right-angled triangle and measured the base, not the side. So, if the kids stand where this little pumpkin is, behind this line, and the tube is up there, I think we'll be a safe distance apart. Let's see how it works. I attached my treat tubes to the railing on my front steps. I added some duct tape to attach it a little more securely. Let's see how it works. Are you ready? All right. It shot out more than 6 feet. You could also make a candy catapult. Now, there are lots and lots of ways to make a catapult, but at its most basic, a catapult is a lever or arm on a fulcrum or pivot point. I chose to make my catapult very, very simple with a pasta spoon for an arm and a sturdy cardboard tube for my fulcrum. And I will rubber band them together like this. Okay. How would you make a catapult? Okay, let's put our candy in the arm and apply some force here. Okay, let's go try it on the front steps now. I figured out that I can put my candy catapult on the same step where I would stand to load my treat tube. That means the kids can stand in the same place on the sidewalk. Before you settle on a place, do make sure that you can reach the kids. With the location of the fulcrum and the angle and the length of the lever. I ended up duct taping my fulcrum to the steps so it won't move around very much. Okay, let's see how it works. 3, 2, 1. If you would like to pass out candy from high above the trick-or-treaters, you could make a candy parachute. Now, I will say this is a lot more work because you would have to make a parachute for each individual treat. But maybe you'll have fewer trick-or-treaters this year, or maybe you just like making parachutes. So here's a simple way of doing that. Take a coffee filter, fold it in half, and punch a hole, however you can, about halfway around towards the edge, like this. And then take a piece of string, this is maybe a foot and a half long or so, tie one end like this, tying a knot, here, and I'm going to tie a knot through the other hole, the other end of the string. There. So this is where you can do things a little differently. The way I attached the candy to the parachute was by winding it around, winding the string around, and then taking a rubber band and rubber banding the string closed. You want to try not to touch the candy a lot, but really just do this the best way that you can. Okay, let's see it how it works in the front. Treats away!
Yeah. Now can I have it?
Yeah? I hope that these ideas will help you have a safe, happy, and socially distant Halloween. I know we're in a tough time, but my hope is that we can turn the challenge of a germ-free Halloween into a problem that we can solve with creativity and determination. Let's try to make the best of a bad situation. And that, my friends, is how we're gonna make it.